Hey, all, Dustin Schaefer here. So we're going to talk about sweeteners. We're going to talk about sugar-free, just concepts. Because what's happening right now is that the keto wave is starting, right? Low carb is becoming finally this concept that we should have been talking about for many, many, many years. But we're now just getting there. And so we're going to talk about some of the sweeteners. So we have some keto-friendly sweeteners. And then we have things that are, if you didn't know, you would think they're keto and they're not necessarily, or they could potentially have a reverse effect on you. So here's the skinny on it all. So just got to watch a few things. I'm going to give you a couple lists on either in this video or above and below here. You're going to get a list of a few things that right now we know to be pretty safe. From a ketogenic perspective or a low carb, if you're going to go low carb, lean on these. Now, why I say is we generally know is that companies right now can make things seem or look a certain way. So we got to be really careful, when you're going low carb. But in general, these are the safe ones. Ethyrol, it's a sugar alcohol, which is really, 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 really safe. Monk fruit tends to be really safe. Monk fruit, the challenge is that the flavoring can shift a little bit. Stevia tends to be very, very keto friendly. Those are the three main. Allulose is another one that it's relatively new, and that one is very ketogenic. Now, sometimes you're going to see people blend them together, and you want to blend those four. Those are going to be the four that you want to kind of lean on the majority of the time. Those should be the more keto friendly sweeteners. Now, it doesn't mean things like Splenda can't still be low carb. The challenge with Splenda is you got to be careful is that they actually lace it with dextrose, which actually still can spike blood sugar and even insulin a little bit. So some people, especially if you're metabolically challenged, may not get a good response with those. So things like Splenda, even though it's low carb, it can still be sometimes a hindrance. And of course, it has some artificialness to it, where the other four that I listed are all natural. So ethyrol, sugar alcohol, stevia, monk fruit, allulose, there's an all natural process to that. So they're real. It's not been processed or synthesized in a lab. Things like Equal, Sweet and Low also can be considered low carb, but now you're consuming something that I would say is below our optimal. If there's something you had from time to time, I wouldn't be disappointed. If it was like sparingly, you had it randomly at random times, I wouldn't worry about it. But if you're going to be low carb and consistently using something, you want to lean on those other four. But I have one that just jumped up, like it has stevia in it, but it's stevia with dextrose. So when you're reading the label, look to see what they're using. If they're binding it with something, that can sometimes, for some people, if they're metabolically challenged, it can throw them out of the tailspin and you don't even know, right? So you're consuming it thinking it's one thing, but it's something else. So read those labels. You want to make sure it's pure, or it's a blend of stevia and ethyrol. Now, xylitol is another sugar alcohol that can be relatively safe. It does spike a little bit, but it's still relatively safe. That's another one that is not so bad, but it's still, you know, not as good as the other four. So of course the obvious ones, the sugars and the brown sugars and honeys and the natural sweeteners out there, agave nectar, those things are all going to spark blood sugar a lot higher and it's a lot higher. So just a little tip, watch out for those sweeteners. They can get a little tricky on you. I've actually seen fat-free water advertised before. Well, water never had fat in it, but they're using it as a tool to advertise it. So be careful with the advertisers. People are maybe going to mislead you a little bit. So just watch it. So you're looking for pure stevia, pure sugar alcohol, ethyrol, not maltose, ethyrol. Xylitol's a little okay. I wouldn't use a lot of it. Allulose and monk fruit are going to be the four you want to lean on the most. Make sure it's pure. Make sure they don't add a lot of binders or anything to it. But they can blend those four together, which I like because it actually can help with some of the aftertaste and things like that. So a blend of those together can be really, really good. So I hope that helps. Watch your sweeteners, y'all.